Hi, let us now discuss about the carotid sheath. This is the carotid sheath. This one is a carotid sheath. It is a tubular investment of deep cervical fascia containing vessels and nerves. So it contains medially common carotid artery and internal carotid artery. That means in the lower part it is common carotid artery, in the upper part of the neck it is internal carotid artery. Laterally it is the internal jugular vein. Laterally it is the internal jugular vein. Medially common carotid artery and internal carotid artery. And in between the two, the 10th cranial nerve, that is the vagus nerve, lying between the two, bit posteriorly. It is posterior and lying between the two. The anterior wall of the sheath, is formed by the pretracheal fascia, and the posterior wall of the sheath is formed by the prevertebral fascia. The lateral and lateral part of the the medial part of the sheath is thick, whereas the lateral part of the sheath is ill-defined or thin, I can say, to allow the expansion of the internal jugular vein during venous return. To be frank, this anterior wall is virtually felt like a loose areolar tissue containing a ramae of ansa cervicalis of cervical plexus, and it is in close association with the pretracheal fascia, whereas the prevertebral fascia is between the prevertebral fascia and the posterior wall. So this is actually the posterior wall of the carotid sheath. Between these two lies a thin layer containing loose areolar tissue . And when there is retropharyngeal abscess, the abscess may spread into this space behind the prevertebral, behind the posterior wall of the carotid sheath and in front of prevertebral fascia. And this fascia also contains, this region also contains the cervical part of sympathetic chain. It also contains the cervical part of sympathetic chain. Now the structures piercing this carotid sheath are, to know that, I would like to go with the longitudinal section of this. So this is the base of the skull. This is a carotid sheath. This carotid sheath extends above to the base of the skull and below to the till the arch of aorta, and structures present here. Medially it is, this is medial side, this is lateral side. Medially it is common carotid artery, which is giving rise to, this is external carotid artery and this is internal carotid artery. So this is common carotid artery, this is external carotid artery, and this one is internal carotid artery. So in the lower part within this sheath, this one is the sheath. In the lower part it is common carotid, in the upper part it is internal carotid within the sheath, and this one is the internal jugular vein. Internal jugular vein lying laterally, and in between the two we see the vagus nerve descending downwards. So this is about the carotid sheath. Now what are the this is a carotid sheath, longitudinal section. Contents you have seen: laterally internal jugular vein, medially common carotid artery in the lower half, internal carotid artery in the upper half, and this one is the 10th cranial nerve or the vagus nerve. Vagus nerve is a wandering nerve which extends, arises from the brain and ends somewhere in the region of the pelvis. Now, what are the structures which are piercing this sheath? Already you know one, that is external carotid artery is already piercing the sheath and going. Although it is external carotid artery, but it is lies internal to the internal carotid artery in the neck. This name is attributed according to its distribution, whether it is going into the and supplying the brain, which is entering into the cranium within the skull, or it is distributing to the head and neck. Accordingly, the name is given. External carotid artery supplies the head and neck region, but it lies medially internally. Internal carotid artery is lies laterally but supplies the brain. Okay. Now the structures piercing the carotid sheath. Number one is external carotid artery. Number two, the tributaries of internal jugular vein, which are the tributaries of internal jugular vein, which are, which corresponds with the names of the branches of the external carotid artery, like superior thyroid vein, number one, lingual vein, number two, facial vein, number three. Superior thyroid vein, lingual vein, facial vein, occipital vein, and posterior auricular vein. So these are the five tributaries of internal jugular vein which pierce the carotid sheath and open into the internal jugular vein. I repeat, number one, superior thyroid vein. This is superior thyroid vein. Number two, lingual vein. Number three, facial vein. Number four, occipital vein. And number five, posterior auricular vein. These names corresponds with the names of the branches of the external carotid artery. External carotid artery gives superior thyroid artery, lingual artery, facial artery, occipital artery, posterior auricular artery, and not only this, it also gives ascending pharyngeal artery and two terminal branches, maxillary artery and superficial temporal artery. But these five veins, which corresponds with the name of the arteries, pierces the carotid sheath and open into the internal jugular vein. So the structures piercing the carotid sheath, number two, are these five veins. Number one is external carotid artery. Number three, I can say the cervical branch of vagus nerve. So this is a vagus nerve, but it gives off a branch in the cervical region, so which is called as cervical branch of vagus nerve. And number four, in the upper part, not only this 10th cranial nerve, 9th, 11th and 12th cranial nerves pass for some distance after emerging out from the respective canals or foramens of the skull. It descends downwards, like the 9th one, that is the 9th cranial nerve, which is glossopharyngeal nerve, ends by supplying the tongue. 10th cranial nerve descends downwards, becoming the true content. 11th cranial nerve, spinal accessory nerve, enters into the posterior triangular region. And the 12th cranial nerve, hypoglossal nerve, ends also by supplying the muscles of the tongue, except for the palatoglossus. So the 9th, 11th, 12th cranial nerves, only in the upper part, are present in the within the carotid sheath, but pierces the sheath and ends finally by supplying its concerned region. So these are overall the structures which pierce the carotid sheath. Clinical importance or applied anatomy of this sheath is during block dissection of the neck to remove the cervical lymph nodes in surgeries, this carotid sheath has to be exposed. This is all about the carotid sheath. Thank you.